Hi friends, today we will discuss about loan origination system. So loan origination system is a part of loan cycle, application process during a loan life cycle is loan origination system. We have a LMS, loan management system, loan servicing. So if you want a loan, first phase will be loan origination system. Today we'll discuss about the points involved or stages involved in loan origination system. So before giving a loan, okay, it may be personal loan or business loan or housing loan, whatever it may be, first you have to make your policies. So in your policies you have to mention what is the CIBIL score you want to approve or reject or overwrite. So example, you mentioned like 650 score, I want to approve. Okay, 650 to 550, I want to overwrite, or less than 550, 400, I want to reject. So these should be set up in policies. Second one is high mark. So what is the high mark you want to approve, and what is the stage you want to reject, what is the score where you want to override? These things you have to mention in policies. Same thing like legal. So after legal verification of your document, what is the action and override? So for example, certain classes you want to override. Okay, TAT, turnaround time. So for the application, what is the turnaround time? Loan verification, property verification, field verification, disbursement, every stage you have to mention turnaround time. So within the turnaround time, it should be completed. For example, 3 days you are given for loan verification. Within 3 days, the loan verification should be completed. Otherwise, it will be escalated. So what are the policies, other policies? Like, is there any check bounce in a customer account? Or he is having an existing account, loan account, and where you found a check bounce, whether you want to reject or you want to consider some 3 checks. Okay, I can override. More than 3 checks, I want to reject. Okay, and other policies like existing loan, any DPD, means overdue is there in existing loan. So if it is 30 over DPD or 60 DPD, where you want to override, where you want to approve, and where you want to reject. These things should be specified in your policies. So if customer having a NPA, existing NPA account, whether you want to override or reject. Market references. When you're giving a loan to a X person or X business organization, you will verify in market. So if you get a positive, you get a negative, then what you want, whether you want to override or reject. Nature of industry. Some industries directly you can set up, like it can be rejected, or some you can say approved, some industries you say override. Restricted industries, any restricted industries by the government or any court or something. So directly, without wasting bank time or customer time, you say like, okay, you are from this restricted industry, we can't give loan. Directly you can reject. These things should be included in policies. So first thing will be lead. So this lead generation can be like, customer can directly go to the branch and verify about the loan, or customer can call bank and he can inquire and he can give the details. So lead will be generated. Or sometimes you can send SMS or email to the bank, or you get a call from DSC. So initially customer will give basic details, what is his name, mobile number, email ID, then lead will be generated. After lead is generated, then we'll capture address, PAN number, loan amount, what is the loan you want. After that, we'll verify the lead, whether is whatever details he has given correct and is interested to take a loan. So if you feel something not matching with your criteria, you can drop the lead. Or you can put it in hold, like after 1 month you want to process that loan. Right now we are not processing a particular loan. Otherwise you can process. Process means lead can be converted as customer. Lead means basic information. Till now, we are not keeping any lead details in our customer data. Just we'll keep it as a lead details. So then first will come CIBIL verification. So what is the CIBIL score you want to approve or process? So if you are approved, then it will go to process. If it is process, then we'll download the CIBIL score, then we'll upload into the system so that it will be available in our database and which can be accessed in other people also in our system, other departments also, they can access the CIBIL score of a customer. So eligibility. So how to, he says I want 50 lakhs. How to calculate eligibility? If he is a salary person, what is the gross salary, net salary, monthly take home? If he is a self-employed, what is the gross turnover, net profit and other income? Self-employed means lawyers, engineers. So they have a own employed business. Business people are government employees, professionals. Every category we have different eligibility categories, eligibility amount. And so now just we are taking the lead and verifications. Now once CIBIL score and all those things are completed, now we'll capture the customer details. Customer details will capture full details of the customer, address, mobile number, everything, and KYC. KYC, you know, like address verification, identity verification, you can capture. And if he is a employee, then you have to capture the employer information also, where he is working, what is his designation, okay, how long is working with the present employer, and what is his total track, income details, what is the income he is getting, whether he is getting salaried income or other income he is getting, what is the experience, total experience and present experience and designation. These things will be captured in customer details. So verification will be, already we have discussed CIBIL verification, Highmark verification. You can reject or overwrite or approve. So all, what about other verifications? PAN verification, whether the application name and the name on the PAN, whether it is matching. KYC verification, address proof and identification. Address verification, home address, office address verification. Employment verification, whether if he is working in a company, we can verify whether he is a whatever given the details are correct or not, whether he is working for the X company. Income and financial verification, salary, if he is getting a salary, form number 16 or income tax return. If it is a rental income, whatever the rental he is getting and whatever it is creating to his account, or is filing any tax return on the rental income, you can find it and you can verify whether it is a correct, genuine document he has given or it is a fake document. You can verify. So then comes for the detailed CAM, for the branch approval, HO approval, depend on the amount, depend on the size. It can be branch, HO, regional office. So depend on the amounts, it can be moved one stage to another stage. Once you get entire CAM approval, we'll give a customer in principle sanction. Like, okay, still now you are not given any confirmation. First time bank is giving, okay, in principle, we are ready to sanction this amount. This letter will be issued to the customer. Then comes to, if it is a housing loan, property verification and validation, document, legal verification, whether it is a legal property or illegal property or government land, or whether this property is verified, validation, whether whatever he said, like 50 lakhs, whether it is a valid for 50 lakhs, everything will verify and will get a proper document. Okay, then it will be loan sanction. So we'll give a proper sanction letter to the customer. So what is the term? 5 years, 10 years, 2 years, what is the loan amount we are given and what are the rate of interest, is there any processing fees, 2% on loan amount plus GST, what is the EMI, what is the schedule, how many months, what is the amount you have to pay, everything we will give it to in sanction letter. So then comes to disbursement, actual amount will be transferred to customer account from bank account or financial institution. So in disbursement you have different stages. We'll go for a disbursement request, then we'll get a branch or RO approval. Then what is the payment mode? whether customer wants a check, DD, NEFT, RTGS transfer. If it is a check, release of check. Then after release and we are given disbursement is over. Now, how to repay the amount? Whether customer has given ECS mandate or what is the collection mode he has given, match he has given, or he has given checks. So everything should be entered into the system. And last, is there any insurance linked to property? So what is the details of the policy? What is the insurance amount? What is the sum assured? What is the premium? These things will be captured in insurance details. Thank you, friends.